So as I mentioned right off the bat, the purpose of the webinar is to discuss what we released in our most recent update, which came out approximately 2 weeks ago. And in that, we have some major enhancements to our storefront, as well as some back-end improvements that will make your dashboard overall more flexible and more capable than it has ever been before. So without further ado, we'll move right into the new storefront. So with the updated storefront, we took an approach in which we wanted to update just about everything look and feel wise. With that, we greatly improved fonts, colors, overall layout and alignment, but we also added core functionality to the way images are handled, from hover to zoom, thumbnails, auto slideshow, etc. And we capped it all off with a brand new checkout page that's extremely streamlined and calls out the most important information better than before. We'll show you a live example of the updated storefront, and Lee will highlight some of the biggest changes and features.
Yep. So we'll take you into an actual example here. And right off the bat, you will notice that the fonts and colors have been updated for the stores in general. The generic bulletin and the shopping cart have both had shadows added to them, popping out a little bit more, the more important information. And if we scroll down, you'll notice that the product requirement tags also received a visual enhancement, as well as the shopping buttons in general, as well as customization options. If we scroll down, you'll also notice that if we hover over images now, that it will zoom in directly on top of the image. And if we click on the image, it will actually enlarge it. So we just have some enhanced functionality going on with that. Instead of doing the multiple dots for the multiple images that you would upload for a product, it will now display as thumbnails. And of course, these are clickable to go to any given image. Another thing that we've updated about the storefront, as we're adding products to our cart and, you know, checking out, we have the pop-up notifications. Those have also received a visual enhancement, this one asking for customization details. So if we add to our cart, you'll also notice, obviously, the shopping cart has been updated. Everything just looks a lot cleaner in general. It really will improve the shopper experience overall, just everything being cleaner and better organized in general. And this is the actual checkout. What we've done here is, of course, also modified everything in terms of the fonts and the display of the products. Same thing for the order confirmation screen. It also received an overhaul.
This is the first of what will be many enhancements and updates to the Teamuniformorder storefront as 2016 comes and we get into the mix. We wanted to also give you a preview of what 2016 is going to look like. And we have our phase two coming on board first thing in January. And that will be the addition of a brand new storefront template that you can choose anytime you build one of your stores. Mm-hmm. In addition to the single storefront template that we're going to debut in January, we also intend on releasing many other templates that are more function-oriented, such as fundraiser-type store templates, promotional product store templates, package store templates, etc., that will make it even easier for you to sell to your larger organizations in the future.
This is an example of a template 2 store. So the first thing I want to point out here is that we now will allow for featured items to be set up. So kind of items that you want to show at the top of the store that are generally more important. As well as images, we're going to allow for larger image displays as far as branding the store. You'll also notice that. And if we scroll down, we're also implementing categories for Template 2 stores where you can actually assign categories to different products so that they're better grouped on the store. And, of course, you can click into these categories to display those products. And so, of course, if we click into one of the products, it will be kind of what you would expect nowadays with online shopping, where you go into the product and you see more details versus everything being on the outside. And this is an example of that, where when you click into a product, you'll see more of the description, and you'll be able to select color, size, and any customizations. And I'll show you one more example here that we have as far as a different template color. Like Derek mentioned, we will be offering different template options, kind of themes of colors.
Now, one thing we want to reinforce is that the existing TUO storefront is not going to go away or change, but in fact, that this new template plus any new templates we add in the future will just be new options for you, making your TUO dashboard even more flexible for any of your more complex needs or more, you know, retail-centric stores that you might launch in the future. So without further ado, we're going to jump into some of the other features that were released as part of our 4.9 update. And some of these you may not have known because they're somewhat in the back end. But the first is we now support Canadian payment types. And for any of you guys that may be in the northern regions of the United States, this is certainly helpful. But we also support Canadian dealerships and a Canadian authorized.net account, which is extremely beneficial going forward as we all continue to expand our businesses. So what Lee is going to show here is that we've now added a country dropdown on the checkout page, as well as in the state and province section. You'll notice if you scroll past all of the U.S. states, you will see all of the Canadian provinces that are available. But this integration doesn't stop just at those two fields. Of course, this was more of a back-end change, and we have tested and confirmed that all Canadian, major Canadian banks are supported through Teamuniformorders.
All right, so this is an example of an updated new version of the store remittance report that you would receive in the case that your payment receiver equals TUO. If we're collecting the money for you, this is the updated file that you would expect to see in the requested remittance PDF download.
This is also basically the same format that we'll use for invoices going forward. We designed them both with simplicity in mind so that all of your stores that are included in either that invoice or remittance are listed out with all associated dollar amounts listed straightforward. And then your credit card fees, TUO commission rates are all broken out individually. In the near future, we will also be including these as PDF files more consistently. I know right now we do Excel files. So we're continuously looking to improve both your experience and the way we handle all internal reports. So a couple other features we'd like to talk about, just in case you missed it, some things that were released over the last month or so. The first of those, I believe, will help you build stores faster than ever before, and that is called default store settings. And in a nutshell, what that is we now give you the ability to, within your main dashboard, set up defaults for about 75% of the options that are required every time you build a store. So we're going to jump over to the dashboard and show you where that can be found and what that looks like when you build a brand new store.
Yeah, so we'll actually go in kind of reverse order with that. We'll actually show first how it's applied. So you'll see whenever you're setting up a brand new Spirit store, you have this use default store settings option. If it is already set up and you hit yes, then you'll notice that it will populate with our profile settings for our default store settings, such as sales tax, any delivery types, the shipping rates, the bulletin where you can also, you know, add any links, things like that, etc. So several options here. I'll go ahead and show you where you can find that now as far as getting it set up. You would go to your profile section and it would be over here under update default store settings. And once we're in there, this is where we can choose to pre-fill all this information for whenever we're setting up brand new stores. It will automatically update once we select default store settings. So just a faster way for you to set up stores.
Now, if you have not set this up yet for your dealer dashboard, we highly recommend that you do it as soon as possible because we've done a couple of speed tests when it comes to building a brand new store. And by using default store settings, you're able to reduce the time it takes to build a store from, let's say, 5 minutes, sometimes longer, to all the way down to a minute or less, if you know exactly what settings and features you want on that store. Huge time saver, and something we're going to emphasize more and more as we continue to improve TUOSystems.com.
And another product type that we made available is our new fundraising feature. And it does display well on the storefront. And you're actually able to do a donation version of the product or a flat rate. And I'll go ahead and give you an example of that. So in this store example, if we scroll down, the first product that we have is the fundraiser product. And of course, this can be created. You'll see if you go to your edit catalog section, you'll have an add fundraiser, and that's how you access this feature. But as you can see, it has a much larger display image and a kind of centered text. Here's what I was referring to before. You either have this donation option where they can donate a chosen dollar amount, or you can have a flat rate option as well. Probably one of the best things about this feature is that we, TUO, do not charge commissions on this feature, so it's a great way for you to offer fundraising for your club, client, or organization.
You know, what we're saying about this feature although you may not profit off of it, we may not profit off of it, it is a value-added feature and something you certainly want to add to your sales toolkit. So when working with your larger organizations, you just give them that option of supporting their organization through a TUO store. Let's say they don't specifically need a TUO store, but they're collecting for a specific purpose or a specific event. You could theoretically set up a TUO store with a fundraiser, and then you can add in a couple optional products to try to gain additional sales during that collection time.
Yeah, and actually this does show up as kind of a separate product inside of your reporting. Especially in the financial report, it's very easy to see how much total fundraising dollars were collected through this feature.
We made sure when developing the feature that it's all discrete, so your fundraising dollars don't get mixed with your product dollars. And we even give you the ability to charge tax on fundraisers if needed. And I'll put an asterisk next to that. Not every state requires you to charge tax on fundraising, but some do. And for some scenarios, that is needed. So we have supported tax for fundraising. And if you need that and you have any questions, we'd be happy to answer further. And the last of the features that we believe are very important, but maybe they missed you or you didn't see them right off the bat, is called available funds for remittance. Now, we don't have anything to show for this feature specifically, but for those of you that use our payment account, our authorized.net gateway, we now on your main dashboard include a value directly in your store called available funds to remit. Yep, and Lee's able to pull up an example here, which is perfect. So you'll notice that in this store, Boyertown Soccer Club, there were a total sales of $8,600. In this case, we have already remitted this store, so the available funds to remit is $0. If we had not remitted it already, there would be a value there. But regardless of whether or not there's a value, if you click that amount, it will take you directly to the request remittance page. And on the request remittance page, you have the ability to see any previous remittances that were requested. So all in all, this is a streamlined feature, help you keep track of any funds that are within the TUO authorized.net account, making it easier for you to reconcile all of your stores on a daily, weekly, monthly basis. The fundraiser feature, it's definitely something that we're excited about. We do plan on expanding our fundraising offerings in the future as well. Currently, we are discussing per product fundraising. So that would be the ability of adding additional dollars or percentages to your products and keeping track of it for fundraising purchases. So more information will come out as we develop that feature and bring it to life. But even beyond that, in a bigger overall view of things, we would eventually like to add a fundraiser store type in which not only are you going to sell products, but maybe the entire store or organization has a fundraising goal similar to crowdfunding. And Lee actually has the idea on this one, but maybe there's some sort of a meter on this storefront that keeps track of the dollars as they're collected towards the overall goal. The sky's the limit with the combination of new store designs and new features that we're working on here at TUO. So just very excited to see how you guys might use this. Well, this has been a pleasure to host this for you guys today. We will be doing another release in December, so stay tuned for new updates and new features. And we hope everyone had a great Thanksgiving and is looking forward to a great holiday season.
Yeah, and definitely if anyone wants to set up an online session, a one-on-one to go through any features or receive any training, just let us know. Feel free to email myself and Derek, and we can definitely get something set up.
We just want to thank you guys for joining us today. And if you ever need anything, we're always available.